Catholic dioceses all over the world continue to reel from sexual abuse allegations against priests and other clergy members. Now, a prominent U.S. bishop says the way forward is to bond together, not to pull apart. In February, Pope Francis held a global summit on preventing clergy misconduct. Earlier this month, he issued a groundbreaking new law requiring every priest and religious sister to report abuse or the cover-up of allegations. Advocates for survivors call it a step forward, even though the bill does not require clergy to file a report with police. Joining me now by Skype is Bishop Robert Barron, author of the new book, Letter to a Suffering Church. A bishop speaks on the sexual abuse crisis. Bishop Barron is founder of the Word on Fire Catholic Ministries and auxiliary bishop for the Archdiocese of Los Angeles. He writes the book in his own name and not as an official response. Your Excellency, welcome back to the broadcast.
Good to be on as always. Thanks for having me.
Why did you title the first chapter of your book, The Devil's Masterpiece?
I think first to highlight the spiritual dimension of the issue, and not to gainsay for a second that human cooperation was very much involved. It's not an either or, but to signal the spiritual dimension of it. And, you know, for the beginning of this crisis, it's always struck me, it's just inadequate to explain this simply by appealing to, you know, human psychology, human machinations. There's something that's just so perfect about the way this crisis has undermined the church. It reaffirmed my belief in a supernatural intelligence that is the enemy of the church. And I just think I agree very much with Pope Francis that to ignore that spiritual dimension is to ignore the key element here.
You said that it is just too exquisitely designed, which I thought was perfect. Your book also highlights St. Peter Damian, an 11th century saint who focused on wiping out sins by clergy members. So tell us the historical connection to today.
I just think it's a distant mirror, to use Barbara Tuchman's famous phrase. We look back at the 11th century and we see in Peter Damian's, cri de coeur, his cry from the heart about the way especially high churchmen were abusing their own spiritual sons. That's what strikes me so much as redolent of the McCarrick situation. And he refers to it as spiritual incest, which I thought was really a apt way to put it.
When you have Theodore McCarrick, who was here at the Archdiocese of Washington and then was later defrocked with allegations of sexual abuse.
Exactly. But when you have spiritual fathers preying on their own spiritual sons, there's something especially nefarious about that. And I think Peter Damian's powerful cry from the 11th century is echoed in the hearts of a lot of Catholics today.
You say that you understand in your book, and I've heard you say it before, the frustration and anger of abuse survivors.
Mm-hmm.
You also say there is never a good reason to leave the church. Can you understand their position?
Sure, and that's a big part of the book. I mean, in some ways, the book is poised between these two poles. The one is understanding fully the anguish and the frustration, the anger of Catholics. Look, I'm a bishop of the church. I spend a lot of my time going out among the people of God. As I say in the book, you know, often clothed in the full liturgical regalia of a bishop. So there I am, beautifully symbolizing for people the church. I have heard this past, 9 months or so, the anguish and the anxiety and the anger of God's people. There's no question about it. And we can't deny it. We can't run from it. So all that's true. And I want to say it as powerfully as I can. At the same time, and to me, it's the most important line of the book, if you want. There's never a good reason to leave the church. Reason to be angry, reason to be frustrated, reason to call for change and reform, absolutely. But there's never a good reason to leave the source of salvation, to leave the mystical body of Christ. Instead, and this is my way of resolving that tension, it's the moment to stay and fight.
Oh, I was just going to say that. It is the time to stay and fight. I pulled it out, too.
Very well put.
We're going to have to leave it there. Bishop Robert Barron, thank you so much. Founder of Word on Fire Catholic Ministries, Auxiliary Bishop of the Archdiocese of Los Angeles, and the author of Letter to a Suffering Church. Thank you, Bishop.
God bless you. Thanks.